To set up match types, you create data sources, create transaction types, and then create match processes. In this tutorial, we cover creating match processes. I'll start by opening the intercompany match type. I can see there are data sources named accounts payable and accounts receivable, and that transaction types have been created, so I'm ready to create match processes. I'll create a match process named Interco. You can create as many match processes as you need. If you're matching debits and credits in a single source system or subsystem, select one for the number of data sources. I'm matching accounts payable to accounts receivable, so I'll accept the default of 2. For matches that require adjustments, you can use either the matching date or the latest accounting date in the transactions being matched as the adjustment date. You use default attribute mapping to set default tolerances for matching attributes between data sources. I'll edit the default tolerance for the balancing attributes to be plus or minus 100. You can optionally use a percentage tolerance. I'll also add a default tolerance for the date attribute of plus or minus 1 day. When you create matching rules, you can override the default tolerances if needed. To simplify navigation of unmatched transactions, you can group them by preferred fields using the bucketing bar. For example, you may want to bucket by location or invoice number, so unmatched transactions with the same value in both sources are shown together. I'll create a bucket using the invoice number. Now I'm ready to create matching rules. I'll start by creating auto-match rules. First, I'll create a rule that requires that the invoice attributes match exactly, but allows a variance of plus or minus 5% for amount. The rule type determines the number of transactions included in matches. I'll select 1-to-1. 1-to-1 rule types match one source system transaction to one subsystem transaction. Select Confirmed for match status if you want transactions that meet the match conditions to be confirmed automatically without user interaction. Select Suggested if you want matches to display in the suggested matches list for review by a preparer. Select No Ambiguous if you want transactions to be matched only if there is only one possible match. I must save the rule before I can add conditions. If a data source has filters, then you can optionally define filtering for the rule. The match engine uses filters to include only the transactions specified by the filter while executing the rule. If the rule type allows many transactions for matching on a data source, then you can define grouping for that data source to summarize transactions by selected attributes into a single transaction for matching. For example, you can group transactions by date or transaction type. I'll keep the rule type as 1-to-1. A condition for matching the balancing attributes is added automatically to every rule and is required. The default tolerance of plus or minus 100 that I defined for the balancing attribute has been applied. I'll select to use custom limits and then select Use Percentage Tolerance. Now I'll add a condition to require an exact match between invoice numbers. Both conditions must be met in order for there to be a match. You use the Adjustment Details tab to configure the information included in adjustments created by this rule. Use the Source to Adjust list to specify the data source to be adjusted by default. Preparers can override this default when approving suggested matches. Select the default transaction type to be used with matches created by this rule. You can provide default values for the attributes. The default values you define here can also be used to populate journal columns when exporting adjustments in transactions to journals. When a match type has more than one match process, auto-matching is run for the match processes in the order they are listed on the match process page. Within each match process, the rules run in the order they are listed in the rules list. Transactions are matched based on the first rule whose matching conditions they meet. You can change the order of the rules if needed. Transactions that do not meet any auto-match rule conditions can be manually matched. You can optionally edit the default manual matching rule. If you do not edit the default manual matching rule, manual matches are allowed only if balancing attributes match exactly. I'm done configuring this match type, so I'll set the status to approve. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.